predictions of solids by using AutoCAD software. First we will go to the AutoCAD screen, switch off the grid mode and switch on the ortho mode, and command is limits. So here specify lower left corner 0, 0, upper right corner 297, 210, then zoom all, then go to line command, take the cursor to the left side of the screen, click on the first button of the mouse and drag the mouse to the right side, take some distance and click on first button of the mouse and take the cursor to the top side and take some distance and click on the first button of the mouse and go to offset, take the distance as 297, select this line, vertical line, and offset to the left side. Similarly, take offset, take the distance as 210, select the horizontal line and offset to the top side, then go to zoom extents and zoom 0.6x and go to fillet between these two lines. Similarly, fillet between these two lines, then go to fillet between these two lines, then go to zoom area. Now we'll go for detext. So take the problem number 139, specify height, take 4 mm, angle is 0, and take 139th problem. So here a pentagonal pyramid 25 mm sides of base, 25 mm sides of base and 60 mm axis length rests on HP on one of its edges of the base. Draw the projections of the pyramid. Draw the projections of the pyramid when the axis is inclined to HP at 40 degrees, at 40 degree, and VP percentage D and VP at 30 degree. Go back to previous one and go to zoom window and then go to layer, click on new, type XY, enter, click on new, type XY and enter, then click on new, type locus and enter, click on new, take axis and enter, click on new, visible layer, enter, click on new, invisible layer. And now go to layer 0, set the line weight at 0.05 and say OK. And XY, click on line weight, make it 0.13 and say OK. Locus, click on line weight 0.05. Then go to axis, click on 0.05 and say OK. Visible layer, click on this and make it 0.5 and say click on invisible layer line weight and make it 0.3 and say OK. And then go to locus, click on line type of locus layer, go to load, click on D dash dot and say OK, and again click on dash dot and say OK. Then go to axis layer line type, click on load, type center C and say OK, and click on center and say OK. Then line type XY, visible, invisible, so click on invisible layer, click on load, go to H hidden and say OK, and take the hidden line type and say OK, and finally come out. Then now you go for a polygon command, then take number of sides as 5, take the edge option and take the first point of edge and drag it in this direction and take temp 25, then go to move, select this and move it still upwards, then go to line, take int of this and perpendicular to this, then you take line int of this, then perpendicular to this line. So now we got between these two, trim it, then go to line, take int of this and int of this, and take int of this, int of this, and here you take int of this and take int of this. Then you draw the xy line here, then go to offset, take the distance as 60 mm. You select this line and offset by 60 mm, and go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this. Then go to line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this. Then go to line, int of this and take perpendicular to this, and take int of this, and then int of this. Then go to line, int of this and take perpendicular to this, and draw intersection point of this. Then go to fillet between these two, and then between these two. Then go to erase, erase this, and go to break, and such that you break this line. Go to CH, go to layer, and take this as axis, and take this line type as 10. Take 10, enter. Then here, click on this, click on this line, this line, this line, this line, and this line. Select this, select this, select this, and select this. Go to layer, click on visible, and go to line weight display and make it visible. Now we have the group command, type group, select objects, you select this entire thing and say OK. Now we need to rotate this, then go to copy, select this and copy this to the next position, and then go to rotate, rotate this, take this object, select base point, take int of this, and here it is rotated in clockwise direction, therefore minus 50 degree, so that it will be rotated at an angle of 40 degrees to xy. Then go to line, take int of this, and you draw this horizontal line, vertical line, take int of this and draw vertical line. Similarly, take line, int of this and draw a vertical line. Then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line perpendicular to this line, perpendicular to this line. Then go to trim, trim, select cutting edges, select this as the cutting edge, then trim this portion. Then go to line, take int of this and line int of this. So here you take a line intersection of these two points and draw perpendicular to this, draw perpendicular to this, then go to line, int of this and draw perpendicular to this, and then go to fillet between these two lines. Similarly, line, take int of this and draw a vertical line, and here take intersection point of this, draw perpendicular to this, then go to line, int of this and draw perpendicular to this, then go to fillet between these two, then go to line, int of this, then intersection of this, then intersection of this, then int of this, then int of this, then type int of this and take int of this. Similarly, line, int of this and take int of this, and then int of this line. Then go to zoom window, then go to break, break this line, first point int of this and say at the rate. Similarly, break first point int of this and say this point. Similarly, break f point int of this and say at the rate. Similarly, break this point f int of this and say at the rate. So now all the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids are visible. You take this, you take this, and you click on this, and you click on this, you click on this, and you click on this line, and these all these things are becomes visible. Just go to layer, make that as visible. Then invisible edges are the edge or a corner which is on XY line in the front view is always invisible in the top view. So you make it invisible. So you go to line type and you type 10. So then escape. Similarly, if in a, from a point, if any one of the edges is invisible, so always up other edges which is emitting out of that point will also becomes invisible. So applying that rule, so these lines are also becomes invisible. You select that and you make it this as 10. So this is how you will be able to do this. Then go to group, shape group, select this entire thing and group it into a single. Then you just zoom previous, then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line. Similarly, line int of this and draw a horizontal line. Then go to copy, select this and copy to the next position and go to line, take endpoint. Then now we need to go for line, take the nearest point on this, the nearest point on this at the rate 100 less than minus 150 degree. Then go to move, select this, move it out, then here, then go to DDIM, select this, modify, then go to primary units, take up to second decimal point, then go to text, take text height as 4, align with the dimension line, centered becomes above, and offset from dimension line is 3, symbols and arrows, take the arrow size as 4, then go to lines, take offset from the origin as 3 and say OK and say close. Then dim horizontal, so take intersection of this and take int of this and it will be 45.96. Then go to circle, take nearest point on this, take the radius of the axis as 60 mm. So then go to break, select this break and you take it out here. Then go to erase, then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line, and then go to circle, take center of this and take the radius as 45.96. then go to break, break this on this side and also on this side, then go to fillet between these two, then go to erase, then go to move, select this, take int of this and take center of this, center of this line. Then go to rotate, select objects, select this, take specify base point, int of this, the rotation angle is 180 degree, that is the reference, take R, take the reference as 180, then the new angle as int of this. Now we have this point, then go to break, select this line and break it, then you select this line, go to layer and make this as locus line and take this as 10 mm. Take this as 10. Now once you do that, then go to zoom window, then go to line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line, take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, and then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, line, take intersection of this and draw a horizontal line, and take int of this and draw perpendicular to this line, and take fillet between these two. Similarly, line, take int of this and draw a horizontal line, take int of this and take perpendicular to this. Similarly, line, take intersection point of this and take perpendicular to this, then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, line, int of this and draw a horizontal line and take int of this and take perpendicular to this line, then go to fillet between these two. Similarly, you take line, int of this, or you take int of this and draw perpendicular to this, and similarly line, you take endpoint of this and draw perpendicular to this. Then go to int of this, take int of this, and 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 take intersection point of this. Then go to line, int of this, take int of this, and int of this, take endpoint of this, and take int of this. Then now, then go to zoom window, then go to break. First point, you take intersection point of this and say at the rate, select break point, first point, int of this and say at the rate. Then go to zoom previous, then go to zoom previous, then here you zoom previous, then you select this line, and you select this line, and this line, and make that layer as XY. Then you just go to zoom window, take near to the screen, all the exterior edges of the boundaries of the solids are visible. You take this, and the surface near to the observer, it is visible. Then you just take these two, then the two edges are, from this point there are two edges are which is visible, so naturally the third edge is also visible. You make that as visible edge. Then since this edge is crossing the visible edge, therefore you make that and also you just go to line, draw a line from intersection point of this to intersection point of this, and you make these two edges naturally becomes invisible, because two visible edges can never cross each other. And applying that rule, so here you take this distance as 10, and then you have the axis line. You take this and go to layer, make this as the axis line, and take this as 10. Then now we need to give the dimensions. So to give the dimensions, go to DDIM, go to modify, go to primary units, make it as 0 and say OK, and say close, dim aligned, select this line, align this with reference to this. Then dim vertical, take int of this and take intersection point of this, and you make this distance as 60, and dim angular, select between this line and this line, you will going to get it as 40 degrees. You take this as 40, and dim angular, select between these two lines and give it as 30, and dim angular, select between this line and this line. So here go to text, take a space, give space, and here, so this angle will be beta. Then go to mtext, then click take the window, go to symbol, select symbol, put up the caps lock and type small letter B, so that will going to become beta. Then go to zoom window, then go to dim TED, select this line, select this arc, then take this, then go to move this text somewhere here. You take this beta here, then go to zoom previous, then remove this, then go to dtext. So here click X, you mark this as VP, and you mark this as HP, and you mark this as Y, and here put up the caps lock, type A, so type B, type C, type D, type E, and here it is O, and here it is O1. Then here you take A dash, you take B dash, you take C dash, you take D dash, then you take E dash, then here it is O dash, and here it is O1 dash, and bracket. Then go to zoom window, select this, move, select objects, select X, VP, and HP, and move it appropriately. Then go to move, take A, and here it is B, here it is C, then D, E, and here it is O, and here it is O1. Then take O dash, and here you take A dash, here it is B dash, here it is E dash, here it is O1 dash, here it is C dash, here it is B dash, then here it is E dash, then go to copy, take this as C dash, take D dash, copy, take D dash, here it is O1 dash, here it is B dash, here it is E dash, here it is A dash, and here it is O dash. Then go to move this here on this O dash. Then go to copy, select A, copy this A here, and that A will come here. Then go to B, copy B here, and that B will come here. And then you take C, copy this C here, and that C will come here. Then D, take D here, and that D will come here. Then here you just move this. Then go to copy, select this E, copy this E here, and that E will come here. And since here O1, since the some of the portions of ABCD is invisible, therefore O1 becomes invisible, and we are rotating that here, so O1 will be here. Then go to copy, take O, and that O will come here, and this O will be here. Then go to D text. So here you type O dash, then you take A dash, and here it is B dash, B dash, here it is C dash, here it is D dash, here it is E dash. Here ABCD is visible, therefore O1 dash becomes visible. Then go to zoom window, select this area, then go to move, take O dash, and here it is A dash, here it is E dash, here it is O1 dash, here it is B dash, here it is C dash, here it is D dash, and here it is E dash, and here it is O1 dash. So this is how you will be able to get the drawing completed by using AutoCAD software. Once you do that, so we can finally, you can break this and then go to move this and place it nearer. So once you do that, now we'll go for a save, go to appropriate directory, go to solid drawings, then type P139 and save it, and finally you